Hey, you're watching Classic Rock Record Review with Gabe and Mary. Today, the album that we're going to review
That's
is.
called the school
Yeah,
set.
so this album is Sweets from a Stranger by Squeeze. It is their fifth album, and it is the last
Squeeze
album by the
the
first incarnation of the
kid.
band
Squeeze the
before they broke up
hamster.
and reformed a few years later.
Let's
So,
squeeze the hamster.
Squeeze the Hamster? Well, let's talk about this record a little bit. So, this album came out in 1982. Maybe, I don't know who the producer is. Let me, if I look down here, I can see. Does it tell me? No, it doesn't. Okay. So, haven't said anything about this record yet. It's one of these records where it's definitely not a very inspired record. It's kind of like a contract obligation type record, but it reminds me a bit of one of those records like there are lots of them. Every band has one. The Beatles have Beatles for Sale. The Who has The Who by Numbers. The Stevie Wonder has Fulfilling His First Finale. It's like, an album where they stop trying very hard to make a good record, but they get kind of introspective and maybe even self-loathing and stuff. It's that kind of record. So, we started off.
That's a squeaky witchy.
Yeah. So, surprisingly, it starts with this kind of 80s sounding thing.
It's from a hamster maze.
Remember Hamster Maze? So, it starts off with a song called Out of Touch. It goes. And the drums come in, and like it sounds kind of cool, like kind of 80s synth pop and stuff. And it kind of gets you stoked for, kind of a hipper record than the record that eventually comes. Because then the following song, despite the great little drum things, is just like this 12-bar blues kind of thing, like not worthy of the name Squeeze. Let's see what I'm talking about. Okay, let's listen to this here. What do you think of this, Mary? Okay. Turn it up. You like this? She was frigid like a Bible when she met. Sounds familiar. Okay, what do you think of that song, Mary? Yeah? So, something I do kind of like about this album is that. But I would say, like the first four Squeeze albums, every album was a little less edgy than the one before it. Like,
Squeeze.
UK Squeeze is kind of punk rock.
Why that
Cool for
squeeze
Cats a little less so.
the hamster?
Argy Bargy a little less so, but it's my favorite. And then East Side Story, which is supposed to be their
Two
masterpiece or
A
whatever, I am
and
tempted to say it's even
both
less edgy. This one kind of starts to have a little bit of a edge rock and roll thing to it again. Let's hear the second song here. I Can't
that's
Hold On.
hamster.
See? That's kind of banging. You like this beat, Mary? Man, that guy's got a golden voice, doesn't he? That Glenn
Now
Tilbrook
turn
there.
that back
And so then
for
that leaves.
them.
Okay, like, how about this one here?
Turn that.
You like that song? How about this one?
Jake
So, this album, by the way, there was a new
wobbly.
keyboard player yet again. That's their third keyboard player. There was Jules Holland, Paul Karak, and then Don Snow, I think, was this guy.
Together we've joined the bride and the church.
even a mediocre album like this, theirs is still like full of these great melodies, man. What's that supposed to mean? She sees solo, I see double. Naughty, naughty. You like that song? Okay, I'm gonna pause that. So the production, I can't remember who the producer is, but the style is kind of like midway between Nick Lowe or Elvis Costello or Dave Edmonds, one of those kind of guys, and like Langer and Winstanley or something. Okay, now this one. This is on here. See, they're getting kind of weird again. I mean, East Side Story is so normal, but then we got this. Casualties and angry young men. Love it, Miss Testa, the guitar and a pen. I really like their drummer, by the way. Just doing like a monkey drummer thing. I love that. I mean, that's cool, you know? Okay, so, okay, how about this? Hey, producer, can you give us that Elvis Costello sound, like the pump it up thing?
Yes, I can.
Thank you. Catchy. And then you got like this jazzy number here. You like this jazzy song?
You can put it on there too.
Okay. There we go. And now we got, of course, Black Coffee in Bed. Superficially, this is like Tempted Part 2, but kind of not really. Tempted's a great song, and this is just kind of like a groove that's similar to Tempted, but it's repetitive. And then you've got like this great pre-chorus, and then like you feel like it's going to come to a chorus, and then that great chorus that you're expecting never comes. And then it just goes back to the beginning, and you're like, oh, that little keyboard riff was the hot part all along? Okay, I guess. And it's like over 6 minutes long. I don't get it. Okay, there we have it. What in the hell kind of keyboard is that, anyways? Here, how about this one?
Very wiggy.
So, a lot of the albums are just kind of not very memorable, like this song. How about this one? There's like a weird stage keyboard or something. This Don Snow guy has a little different keyboard sensibility than the previous two keyboardists. So that's Chris Difford singing. That kind of usually does the lower octave when they do their parallel octave thing. It's got this kind of neatly off-key voice. He sang such previous hits as Cool for Cats and Someone Else's Heart. I like it. It kind of shakes things up having, you know, the other guy who's not as good of a singer sing a song every once in a while. Like, I always like the Oats song or two on every Hall & Oates record. There we go. Okay, there we are. Now we got some kind of weird stuff here. When Squeeze reunited a few years later with an album called Costi Fan Tutti Frutti, that album was absolutely bonkers. And this song here kind of hints at what they went for on that album. Totally bonkers album. Takes a while to grow on you, but when it does, it does. Now that's cool. It just kind of changes gears and like goes into this Hall & Oates kind of territory. You like this song, Mary? It's called The Very First Dance. Okay, and now let's hear the last song. Let's hear a little sample of The Elephant Ride. Isn't there a Chris Isaak song that sounds a lot like this? Who cares? Yeah, like the opening track on Heart-Shaped World, which might be called Heart-Shaped World. It sounds a lot like this. 96 Tears sounds a lot like this too, the major to minor back and forth thing. It's a little weird, it's kind of atonal. More so than their previous album by a lot. There we go. So, the moral of the story, Sweets from a Stranger, even a mediocre Squeeze album is still a pretty good record. So, Sweets from a Stranger, A minus. What do you think? Do you like this record, Mary? I realize we just listened to a few seconds of each song, but you like these songs, Mary?
And you lost your other one.
What did I lose, Mary?
Oh, that other thing that was up here.
Oh, I'm not sure what you're talking about, Mary.
Oh, you just dropped it down.
Was it a guitar pick?
No.
Was it a microphone?
No.
What was it, my girl?
It was a downstairs thing.
A downstairs thing. Oh, yeah. You know those downstairs things. Okay. All right, Mary.
It's going to be right there.
Okay, you want to say bye-bye to the screen?
Bye-bye, the screen.